That note. Welcome back to my little pad in Mount Eliza, Victoria, Australia. It is the 7th of April today. I'm not sure what date it'll be when you're watching this video, but you know, it doesn't really matter, does it? I've got in my hands a J-caster from my friend Jason Baulk at JMB Guitars here in Melbourne. Jason is building these guitars one by one with painstaking detail to perfection. And this is Jason's here in the room with me, by the way, so I've got to flatter him. This is no exception. So this J-caster features, once again, the same pickups that are in my J-caster, which are Ben Bailey's 51 no-caster set. Is that, I think that's what he calls them, isn't it? Ben is from South Australia. Great pickup winder. So we've got a Holy Grail in the back, which is kind of like a reasonably hot broadcaster pickup. Reads at about 9K, doesn't it?
I think so, yeah.
It's something like that. And then a Bluesmith here. This guitar has got the twang, man. This is, I'll call it a J-caster exotic because of the Blackwood top, which comes from the Otways here in Victoria. Gorgeous figuring on it. The body is made from Huon Pine, which is, comes from the hardwood forests of Tasmania. You can see that it's finished in a beautiful Jarrah stain with the single-ply binding top and back. The neck is made from a Queensland maple, and the fingerboard is made from another hardwood that's local to Australia called Gidgee. And Gidgee is just about as hard as mulga, which we find on the other J-casters, a little more porous. So it's a bit darker and it feels a bit more like rosewood. It's not as kind of hard and unforgiving as the mulga is. I love the mulga too, by the way. Medium jumbo frets on a 9.5-inch radius. These frets are of the cryogenic variety that I believe is available from Stewie Mac, right? So a bit harder than nickel, but not as tingy as stainless steel, somewhere in between the Goldilocks fret, we'll call them. Man, it is a smooth ride. This neck, you might have seen my other J-caster video that I put up a little couple of days ago. This one, this neck's a little bit thinner in terms of its profile, so a bit more like a 50s neck, I suppose, you could say. Is it 43 at the nut?
Yes.
43 at the nut, so it's got
C-shape.
C-shape, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. We've got Goto graduated, height graduated machine heads, which are always great. The Goto bridge with the 6 adjustable saddles and the 3-way switching system with the pull-up series switch. So that series is adding a little bit of body because it's running both of these in series, so you've got actually 4 positions and you can pull out the series at any time. The amp, by the way, is a classic early 60s blackface deluxe reverb model in the axe. The models are great because I can call up any amp I want. And a telly always works well with a deluxe reverb. This is not a telly, though. This is a J-caster. I must point that out or we'll both be in trouble. Thank you. It's great. Is this yours or is this one sold?
No, this is for my mate's dad. So that's...
It's for your mate's dad. Well, congratulations, Mr.
Hutchins.
Bernie Hutchins, sending you a cheerio from Mount Eliza. Is Bernie local to us?
Yeah.
Okay.
He refers to himself as my biggest fan.
As your biggest fan? Oh, that's nice.
He's going to be chuffed to get that.
He will.
He's getting it yet, so.
Oh, wow. What a surprise.
Yeah.
Damn. Okay, well, well done. Congratulations to you, sir. It's a dream guitar. He's a very lucky man, and you're a very talented fella.
Thank you, Brett.
The J-caster from JMB Guitars. I'll leave the links so you can get one of your own underneath the video. Thanks for watching. See you soon.